the market has sought to become the most dominant feature of our economic development. And the state, which once was introduced primarily to limit the detrimental effects of the market, to stabilize, to promote growth, to temper inequalities, and to cultivate civic pride, has now retreated and taken a back seat. The state, in an earlier dispensation, would have provided employment protection legislation, minimum standard social protection, a regulatory framework for the conduct of business. It would have also recognized, as we do in our labor relations code, that work is a social right and obligation, it is not a commodity, and that dignity must be accorded to all work and workers. We have seen the development and facilitation of trade unions and the critical role that they have played, both at a macro level and at the collective bargaining level, to balance an otherwise unequal relationship that exists between labor and capital, and more importantly, to ensure that we minimize what obviously has been a tendency, if we look in our historical circumstances, the tendency to exploit labor.